In this video, you'll be shown a strategy for annotating digitally using the browser extension Hypothesis. This strategy can help you enhance your learning in the remote environment. Annotation is the act of highlighting and adding notes to a document. It is a great way to help you understand what you are reading. Not only does annotation encourage you to slow down and take note of what is important in the text, the annotated document can then be used as a reference tool that can help you review the key points in the reading. While some of you may prefer making your notes on paper, some might find it easier and more convenient to just annotate digitally. This can be especially helpful since nowadays, most of the content you are reading is probably digital anyway, with many of your online courses using e-textbooks. For this video, we will be using Hypothesis, which is a browser extension that allows for you to annotate PDFs and web pages. Before you begin, I just wanted to let you know that this video is inspired by the Kwantlen Polytechnic University's article titled "Take Effective Notes on Online Readings." Now, before we can start annotating, you're going to want to install Hypothesis onto your browser. We recommend using Google Chrome, as this extension works best with it. In a moment, you should pause this video and go to web.hypothes.is/start. Follow the simple instructions there to create your account and install the browser extension. Okay, now when I say pause, pause the video and follow the instructions just mentioned. Make sure to unpause when you're done. Ready, set, pause. Welcome back. If you have done everything correctly, you should see, depending on your browser, a little speech bubble with an H inside of it in the top right corner of your screen. Right-click on the extension and click on Hypothesis, Web and PDF Annotation. This will take you to your profile. This page is where your annotations will be once you create some. Before we begin annotating, it might be a good idea to create a group for where we can store our annotations. This is because by default, when you do not save your annotations to a group, the annotations will be public and visible to anyone who uses Hypothesis. Aside from this, groups are also useful for when you and multiple people want to annotate different documents and view those annotations in one central place. To create a group, go to the top right corner to Groups. Once you make a group, it will be shown in the drop-down menu. Click on Create a New Group. Give it a name and a description. Once you're done, click Create Group. Once you do so, you'll be redirected to a page similar to the main one. Here, you can store your annotations, if you do not want them public or want to share them easily with others. Now, let's get to annotating. To annotate a PDF for a website, you can just go to the URL where it is stored and click the speech bubble icon that I mentioned earlier to begin annotation. If the PDF you wish to annotate is stored on your computer, right-click on it and open it with Google Chrome. This should open up the PDF to where you can then annotate it. Once you click on the Hypothesis icon, you will notice three icons appear in the top right corner of the screen. The side arrow allows you to open and close the sidebar. The sidebar is where your annotations will be displayed and where you can input page notes. Up here, you'll see Public. Click on it, and then select the group you just created. The eye icon is where you can show/hide your highlights. The sticky note icon is where you can add a page note. Let's close the sidebar for now. To begin highlighting, simply highlight text with your cursor, and then click on Highlight. To annotate, do the same thing, only this time once highlighted, click on Annotate. The sidebar will appear with a text box to where you can type in your annotation. Once you're done, click where it says Post To, and then your group name. To go back to Hypothesis and see your annotations, once again, right-click on the Hypothesis icon and click on Hypothesis, Web and PDF Annotation. There, you should see your new annotation listed. If you click on it, it will show you a list of your annotations. To visit the document again, click on Visit Annotations in Context. To better organize your annotations, you may find it helpful to create different groups for each course you are taking, so that you can save the appropriate annotations to that particular group. It is also a good idea to frequently revisit your annotations as needed prior to an examination, paper, or project, so that you can interrupt the forgetting. And that's that! You've now seen how to annotate digitally using Hypothesis. Now it's time to practice this strategy yourself, so that you can become more familiar with this useful browser extension. For more information on academic support resources and strategies, visit us at usm.maine.edu/agile.